Living green or sustainably is about more than saving on your electric bill and doing your part to protect natural resources. It is about a safer and healthier life for you and your family without sacrificing style, quality, or budget. This is a movement to provide all of us with clean air to breathe and water to drink, safe, healthy food to eat and places to live, and energy to run the places where we live, learn, play, and work. The Everyday Green Home Podcast helps you get the value of green for you, your family, and your community. Whether it's green homes, green living, or the people who make it happen, join me, Marla Esser-Close, to learn how green and sustainability practices and products work for you and our world. Hi, Marla, the Green Home Coach here. I'm really excited to be doing these teach talks and just an opportunity for us to explore some different things around your home that you may be able to do a little differently. And, you know, right now, health and wellness is like, I mean, it's everything right now. We're all just so focused on this and it's so centered around our homes. We're living in our homes so hard. We're using our homes in ways we really didn't ever expect to. And it's just where we're doing everything. I mean, we're living here, we're working here, we're playing here, we're educating, we're recreating, we're shopping. And all of that just means that we're putting a lot more wear and tear on our homes. We are finding things about our home that we wish were different. And so maybe you've been rearranging furniture, changing out decorative elements in your home, or maybe you started cleaning differently, or all of the above. So today I want to focus on cleaning. I know that sounds kind of right? But here's why. So cleaning is like one of the ways you can really impact the health and wellness that you and the other inhabitants of your home. Yeah, how you experience your home is so much of a part of how you take care of and how you clean it. It also super helps the maintenance side of your home because you maintain through cleaning and that lengthens the life of things. But I think I'm going to do a separate teach talk on that later on in the year. Because today I really wanted to focus on this health and wellness aspect. And I'm recording this in February. And, you know, this is normally flu season anyway, flu and cold season. And now we've got the pandemic and you know, it's been going on a while. And so we've adapted, but we're also realizing that there's ways to do things that just make more sense in a long time going forward basis. And I heard today in a session I was listening to that healthy is the new green. And that was just perfect. So totally perfect. And the way we think about our homes has changed. It's changing. And how we clean them is a big part of that. So today, I really want to walk through the process of how you can clean, because how you clean matters. What you clean with matters. It matters because A, you want something that really works and hopefully doesn't take a lot of extra work from you. And B, you want something that's not going to negatively impact your health and wellness. So you don't want to use cleaning products that have a bunch of yucky chemicals in them that could off-gas for your family and you and whoever else lives and inhabits at home with you and your pets. Oh my gosh, we don't want chemicals around our people or our pets or ourselves. And so that's a really big thing. And I think a lot of times we don't always think about it because we've just grown up with all these things that we've used for cleaning. And there's so many choices out there. It really could be overwhelming. Even in the non-toxin chemical-free space, there's so many choices and there's a lot of subscription services coming out. So want to read the labels. And ironically enough, some of the ones I'm going to show you today, you can see the ingredients on the labels. Some of them have green labels, some of them don't. So I'm going to show you some options that I use. I get the honor because I get to do this for you guys. I get to do a lot of testing with different products, which makes it really fun. So first thing to cleaning your home, you want to remove the debris, the dust, the dirt, just get it off. You want it to go away. How do you want to do that? So a couple of tools I use. Number one, I don't use paper towels unless there's like a really nasty pet mess or something on the floor. I use these. I have all colors. my green one, my orange one, my blue one. We use these in our home. These are microfiber cloths and they're wonderful. And just throw them in the wash with our towels. They almost kind of have a Velcro feel to them. So this side, you can tell we really use these. They're really kind of worn looking. This side feels kind of textury, kind of like terry cloth. And this side is smoother. So we use these for just about everything. I will say we polish things with like a tea towel. And I did not bring a tea towel in, but a more like a linen-y feeling or a cotton tea towel. That tends to polish a lot better. So after we clean with these and we come follow up to polish like stainless steel appliances or mirrors or glass items, we'll come back and do a quick polish afterwards. So what you use on your glass and your stainless steel can really matter. So I have a couple of different products from different product lines. Both of them made by friends of mine, which is really cool. So Shabby Chick is a company, woman owned here in Oklahoma, and all natural, lists the ingredients on the back. So I know exactly what's in them. I've been down to actually help her make them. So I got to see it firsthand. We really like this. And my husband, Scott, helps to clean around the house. And he particularly likes the all-purpose cleaner. And it tackles our nasty, grody stove like nothing we've ever seen. So at any rate, this company makes two cleaners. And this is all you need. All-purpose cleaner, stainless steel and glass cleaner. This one, non-streaky. This one, tough, soapy, get it clean formula. So you have options like this, which you can order online. My camera's doing really funky things. They work great with our microfiber cloth. You also have other all-purpose cleaners. This one's Better Life. This one was actually founded by two guys in St. Louis, where I used to live. They also make a lot more products. So rather than just having two products to clean with, you have quite a selection. This is the natural and stainless steel. So they have that cleaner. They have a special floor cleaner, toilet bowl cleaner, et cetera. Honestly, we can make do with just a couple of cleaners. And then if we need scrubby power, we have an all natural scrubby cleaner in the house, or we can add some baking soda, or I have, and I didn't bring one in here either. We have scrubby pads that we can use. I even use them in our sinks, just real light scrubby ones to get off like some soap scum and stuff. Works in the shower great too. So those are some options. So you're also going to need to remove dust and dirt and debris from your floor. So we use these mops, if you will. This is a dust mop on here, just been used, so it's a little dusty. These just come off and toss in the wash. And this company happens to make a lot of different products, as well as a floor cleaner that is Green Guard certified. This is Bona, B-O-N-A. And most of this stuff is on my online shop, if you want an easy way to find it. A lot of it you can find in your store. You can find it online at your favorite retailer, et cetera. So anywho, back to dust and dirt removal of your floor. So this is for like dust mopping. So we use this on our wood floors. And we also try to vacuum just to remove the dust once in a while and then use this in between. It also has a mop pad, which you can wet and use like on our tile floors, because we do have tile in some of our rooms. And then we also have... the mops are bigger than me. This is a really big head. This is a different brand. Same idea. But what I love about these is that they come off. So the lady that cleans my mom's house, that helps her clean, actually takes the one that is the Swiffer. And she actually takes, and it might work with this one, the Swiffer version, a different brand, has little like punch holes that you can do on this side where you normally put the disposable cloth in. And she taught me this great trick. She takes one of these microfiber cloths, actually it does work on this one. So it just attaches to the Velcro and away you go. So if you don't have mop heads, but you do have a Swiffer head or one with the Velcro on it, this is a great way to use something reusable rather than having something you need to throw away. Because if we can clean without having to create extra trash that goes in the landfill, yay, that's even better. So that's a great option as well. So what else can you use to clean? We have some specialty tools with microfiber cloth. This one is for blinds, horizontal blinds. Doesn't work so well in vertical blinds. The spacing's not right. But this is great. You just put it around your blinds, squeeze it, go across, super duper. This comes off, goes in the wash. So all of this stuff that goes in the wash, I love, 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 love. We have handled items. I didn't bring my fan one in, but we have one on an extension pole that we can use to clean the tops of our ceiling fans, which, by the way, you don't want to forget. Otherwise, that dust is just kind of hurling around in the air. But these work great on getting in tight places, places you can't reach with your microfiber rag. There's something stuck in there. And again, these just come off and go into the wash. So all of the stuff that we use to clean really just goes on the wash, makes it super easy, and away we go. So I showed you a few of the products that we use to clean. So we also want to get dirt and debris off. So the floors, the furniture, surfaces, countertops, bathroom surfaces, faucets, ledges, windowsills, blinds, ceiling fans, and don't forget your lamps, your light bulbs. Actually leaving that dust on the light bulbs can reduce how effective they are. So that's a great way to clean them up as well. Now, if you are a do-it-yourselfer, which I'm not great at do-it-yourself in the kitchen, a lot of folks can make great cleaning products out of cleaning vinegar. This is stronger than regular vinegar. Lots of recipes online for different cleaning formulas using vinegar, lemons, and baking soda. Baking soda, by the way, makes a great scrubby powder to put in with any of your cleaners. It's slightly abrasive. I can't see it very well from here, but you guys know what baking soda looks like, right? You know, so it's just slightly abrasive. Can mix it in with water or your favorite cleaner, and it gives you that little abrasive, that light abrasive quality. So that's definitely a great one. The other thing that we do, side note, we put baking soda on our carpets and rugs and vacuum it up to get them freshened up. And that works really, really well. Deodorizes, especially if you have pets, because our dog is kind of a smelly little guy. Anyway, so that really helps to freshen things up. Baking soda, vinegar, and lemons. If you're a DIYer, they are your friends for cleaning. Then you don't have to buy as much product. So even better, right? Okay, we got all the dirt, the dust, the debris removed. Why is it so important to remove all this? Because if you remove the dust, the debris, et cetera, it also removes whatever else may be clinging to that. Germs, viruses, bacteria, et cetera. It removes them, not all of them. Removes some of them, but it at least reduces the number. So this is another reason to clean by removing the dirt. Next, you want to sanitize and disinfect. Now you need an EPA registered disinfectant. And you can go to the EPA's website and you can look for registered products. Most of them have some pretty heavy duty chemicals in them. So we found two different products that work very similarly, and I'm not going to get the names of what they do. One of them is Force of Nature, and you pour the water in here, you turn a little switch on, it does its magic and fizzes and formulates, and it makes a cleaner that smells and tastes like a little bit like pool water, but it has converted the water and a little bit of vinegar and salt into two new ingredients that are totally safe. It just rearranges the molecules to make this totally safe. It is a cleaner, so clean with it. It works pretty darn good. And then leave it on per the instructions. I can't remember, it's a few minutes. And then it disinfects and sanitizes. That's what's required to kill the germs and the viruses, is sanitizing and disinfecting. That's really, really important to follow the instructions and leave that solution on for the recommended time. If you've ever used the alcohol-based hand sanitizers, most of them tell you to let it stay wet for at least 20 seconds. I use a plant-based alcohol hand sanitizer, also from Shabby Chick. 20 seconds, I spray it on and let my hands dry for at least 20 seconds, and then the alcohol has gone to work killing germs and viruses on my hands. So safe alternatives to big chemical sanitizers and disinfectants, Force of Nature is one. The other one is the Tersano Eye Clean. This is a newer one that I have been exposed to. That's not a word. This one, what I love is that it makes it on the fly. So you fill up the little reservoir, you put the lid on, and it makes a formula on the spot. And my hand's wet. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah, there you go. So I just sprayed it and voila. Now, okay, this one's weird, folks, because it tastes just like water. All I put in the bottom was tap water. This is pretty incredible. So this one, uses the technology inside to electrolyze the water. I hope I'm saying that right. I'm not the science technical part on this. But this continuous flow converts the regular water into an EPA registered disinfectant and sanitizing agent. When you're done, just pour out the water, let this dry, because it only needs, you don't want this to sit in the water for more than about 15 or 20 minutes. And from there, you just let it dry and then you fill it up next time you need it. This one is a brand new concept. Both this and Force of Nature work well to clean, and then you leave them on for the prescribed amount of time to get that disinfection and sanitizing effect. And that's important. You can see both of them are EPA registered if you go to the EPA website. So a great way to sanitize and disinfect around your home. It's not going to be using the icky chemicals, that is using just tap water. It's a really different paradigm shift, though, for us to think about an appliance. You know, both of these are appliances. So you're not buying a solution to clean with, you're buying an appliance that makes that solution ongoing. And I say in particular that it's an appliance because it seems a lot more expensive than a cleaner does. But you got to remember, these are going to last you for years. So you have to spread that cost out over the years and the cost of you having better health effects from using these much safer alternatives that don't have the chemicals in them. Both of these are available on Everyday Green Home and will take you to their respective product pages to learn more about them. They both have a lot of testing run, and that's really, I've had to rely a lot on the testing because it's hard to tell since it just seems like water. So it's really different. Very exciting technology, though. Very exciting technology. Okay. Wow. That was a lot. So let's move on. So let's think preventative, because I don't know about you, but I'd rather not clean as much if I don't have to. So one thing we do is we have several doormats at our doors, both in the back and in the front. So we have outdoor doormat. If I could take my camera around and show you my doors, I would. I've got a couple of pictures, so I'll attempt to post those in the comments to this later on. But so we have an outside mat. Actually, mine's made from recycled tires, so that's even better. And then I've got two mats indoors coming in the front door because we come in the front door a lot and the dog does too. And what happens is that those mats catch the dirt, so we're not tracking in as much. I would like to go to a shoe-free household. We've not been able to do that yet because our floors are super hard and we have some knee issues in the house. So we're trying to figure out how to get that to work. Plus, it's really cold on our floors right now, and it's because it's wintertime. But we have that double mat inside and outside on all of our doors, including the one in from the garage. And what that does is that helps to capture that dirt so you just don't bring it into the house. That works with buildings, businesses, houses, just a way to capture that dirt so you don't have as much. Other ways to capture the dirt. You're cleaning your filter for your heating and cooling unit. If your system will handle a MERV 13, that means that it's more filtering. Yeah, it's more filtering. And they tend to be about 4 inches thick. So you need to check with your heating and cooling contractor and make sure your unit can handle it. I also use a different kind of a filter called a green screen filter, which I'm sure some of you have seen. I will link to that in the comments as well. It works on a different principle than the pleated filters. It looks more like kind of a styrofoam mesh, and it captures the particles, the dirt, the dust, and then some of the viruses and some of the bigger viruses. Some of the little bitty ones are a lot harder to catch. So this is another type of filtration you can use. You really need more filtration. Look at HEPA filters with air purifiers and air filtration. You can get room or whole house models. So there's lots of options to filter the air. Why would you do that? If you've got extra sensitivities or you want to make sure you're getting everything out of the air and keeping it as clean as possible, these work best when you also have fresh air coming into the house to keep the fresh air rotating through. Ventilation is a whole conversation in and of itself, and we will do that one in another Teach Talk. The other thing to think about is you can also use plants in your home to clean some of the chemical toxins and pollutants out of the air. And there's been some great research done by NASA, and there is a clean the air plant list. I didn't say that exactly their way, but you get the point. So those plants can also help. You do need a fair amount of plants in order to really help clean the air, but anything is a good place to start. So those are all capture ways, ways to capture some of that dirt, dust, and whatever else is floating around in the air and on our shoes and clothes and everything else, and to capture that. So you're not having to clean as much. So what else can you do? And we've been working towards getting on a schedule where we have certain things that we do daily, just quick 5-10 minute cleanup kinds of tasks that we can do throughout the day, just to keep everything moving quicker. And so that when we do need to do the full house clean, we don't have to do as much. So we have those daily tasks, and then we have the weekly tasks, you know, from mopping and dust mopping and dusting the furniture and cleaning the bathrooms and all that. And then monthly, we try a deeper clean on one or two items. So maybe it's cleaning the baseboards with a wet sponge. By the way, speaking of that, a really great trick is when you're using your microfiber cloths, just take a couple of quick spritzes of water. Don't make it wet, just damp. And it will pick up the dust a lot better. That way you don't need dusting sprays, and it just removes the dust a lot more efficiently. So when you're working on that schedule, you still got your same bevy of tools and solutions and things to help you out. And the other thing I want you to keep in mind is, you know, I think a lot of us are talking about simplifying and decluttering right now. And the nicest thing about that is it's fewer things to clean, fewer things to collect dust. And I'm actually starting to take some things out of my home, like dried flower arrangements, because they just hold dust and dirt. So some of those items I'm just finding don't fit our needs right now quite as much. So you might look through your home as you're cleaning, rearranging, whatever you're doing, and see what items might be dust collectors that you can take out of your home and just simplify your life a little bit. So there you go. That's my tips on cleaning for your health and how you can go about doing it. To recap, you want to clean with safer, healthier products so you don't have the issues that may arise with chemicals you don't know about and there may be situations with. You want to capture the dirt, the dust, and all those lovelies with reusable cloths, dust mops, and sponges and other tools so you can toss them in the wash. And then you want to disinfect and sanitize where you need to keep your home safe. And there's lots of really great options now. So if you have any questions, please post them wherever you'd like. You can find me on Instagram and Facebook at Green Home Coach. You can find us in the podcast world. And you can always go to the website to contact me as well, greenhomecoach.com. Thank you so much for this Teach Talk, and I hope you learned something new today that you can put in place in your home. Because remember, the thing that matters most is just taking action.
That wraps this episode of the Everyday Green Home Podcast. Get the show notes with all the resources mentioned in this episode, and be sure to subscribe on your favorite podcast app so you never miss an episode. Ready to get started? Get more information, how-tos, and resources in my private Facebook group, Love Your Everyday Green Home. See you there. And remember that living a little better and a little greener is easier than you think.